Hi viewers, this is PPG in front of you once again. Now today we will discuss the difference between the prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell. Now before differentiating between the prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell, we will understand the eukaryotic cell separately and the prokaryotic cell separately. Until and unless we understand the eukaryotic cell separately and the prokaryotic cell separately, we would not be able to differentiate between them. So it is very important to understand what you mean by eukaryotic cell and the prokaryotic cell. So before discussing the eukaryotic cell, first of all, let us understand what you mean by eukaryotic cell. This is the biomedical word. Now I will tell you the technique how to decipher the biomedical word. Now see, here it is written over the board. Eukaryotic cell. Cell is noun, as you all know, the cell is noun, and this word is before the cell, and it has got the suffix IC. IC is the adjective suffix. So wherever we will get the IC at the end of any word, that means that particular word is the adjective. This is the prefix U. U means true. Karyon is the word root, which means the nucleus. And IC is the adjective suffix. It means R full stop T full stop. In short, we can write R full stop T full stop means relating to. So the cell, number 1, relating to, number 2, true, number 3, nucleus. This is called the eukaryotic cell. I am coming once again. Cell is the noun and eukaryotic word is the adjective. It is because IC suffix is present at the end of this word eukaryote, which means to, relating to, then we'll decipher or decode the meaning of U. It means true. Then this is the karyote. Karyote has come from the word karyon, means nucleus. So we have broken the word in three pieces: number 1, number 2, and number 3. So while deciphering the biomedical word, we'll first describe number 1, the suffix, then the prefix, and then the word root. So the cell relating to true nucleus is called the eukaryotic cell. I think you have understood. Now let us check out why it is called the true nucleus. See, this is the nucleus and this is the cell. This is the nucleus, and the true nucleus has got four components. So that this is the dense structure is called the nucleolus. Then highly coiled structure is called the nuclear reticulum or chromatid reticulum. Highly coiled structure is called the chromatid reticulum, and the colloidal structure present inside the nucleus is called the nucleoplasm. And number 4, this is the nuclear NM, nuclear membrane. So all these 4 components are present in the true nucleus. I am coming once again. Number 1, nucleolus. Number 2, nuclear reticulum or chromatin reticulum. Number 3, nucleoplasm. And number 4, nuclear membrane. So, if in this cell true nucleus is present, then that cell is called to be eukaryotic cell. Then we are coming to the structure of the cell wall. The cell wall of eukaryotic cell is composed of cellulose. It is composed of cellulose. The cell wall is composed of cellulose. And in most of the cases, we do see, apart from cellulose, there are pectin, hemicellulose, lignin, suberin are also present. Now, in the eukaryotic cell, we do see all the cell organelles which are supposed to be present are all present inside the cell. Now, take a look. This is the plant cell. Here mitochondria is present, plastid is present, endoplasmic reticulum is present, Golgi body is present. So, all the four main or important cell organelles which are supposed to be present are all present in the eukaryotic plant cell. Now, eukaryotic cell may be plant cell, may be animal cell. Now, in the animal cell, this plastid will not be present. Instead of plastid, we will find centrosome, right? So, the eukaryotic cell has got the true nucleus, then the cell wall consists of cellulose, maybe hemicellulose, pectin, lignin or suberin are present. All the important cell organelles are present. This is called the eukaryotic, the features of the eukaryotic cells. Now, where we will find the eukaryotic cells? The eukaryotic cells are present from unicellular to multicellular, in case of plant as well as in animal. In case of plant, the unicellular eukaryotic cells are, take example of Volvox, Udogonium, Chlamydomonas, the multicellular algae are Spirogyra, then all the fungi like yeast, mucor are eukaryotic cells, then all the bryophytes are eukaryotic cells like moss, then all the pteridophytes are like fern are grouped under this eukaryotic cells, and all the angiosperms, gymnosperms are categorized under the eukaryotic cells. They do have the eukaryotic cells. In case of animal, we do see that the amoeba is having the eukaryotic cell, the sponge, then the Ascaris, then all the platyhelminthes, all the nematelminthes, all the annelids, all the arthropods, all the echinodermatas and chordates are having the eukaryotic cells. So, let us take a look what I have just told just now. Let us recapitulate the things. Eukaryotic cells, cells relating to true nucleus is called the eukaryotic cells. The eukaryotic cells may be unicellular or multicellular. The cell consists of cellulose. The nucleus is true. The cell organelles are present. And number 5, ribosomes are ATS. Here ribosomes are present. These are ATS. That means the 40S plus 60S equals to 80S. This is the feature of ribosomes in case of eukaryotic cells. 60S plus 40S plus 60S equals to 80S. It is not 100S because 60 unit ribosome and 40 units of ribosome are get attached in this form. So, 20 units get superimposed. So, the results it comes out to be 80S. So, 40S plus 60S equals to 80S ribosomes are present in case of eukaryotic cells. Now, take a look of the prokaryotic cells. Similarly, prokaryotic cells, the cell relating to pro means primitive. Karyo means carrion, means nucleus. So, number 1, number 2, number 3. The cell relating to primitive cell relating to primitive nucleus is called the prokaryotic cells. Now see, why it is called the primitive nucleus? See the structure of nucleus. Only naked DNA or RNA is present. DNA is the deoxyribonucleic acid and RNA is the ribonucleic acid. Either DNA is present or RNA is present in the prokaryotic cells. Now take a look of the nucleus. No nuclear membrane is present. No nuclear membrane is present. No nucleus is present. No nucleoplasm is present. Only naked piece of DNA or RNA is present. That is why it is called the prokaryotic cell. And it is unicellular. All the bacteria are clubbed under the prokaryotic cells. The cell is made up of mucopeptide. The cell wall is made up of mucopeptide. The nucleus is primitive and the cell organelles are absent. All the important vital cell organelles are absent in case of prokaryotic cells. And the ribosome is 70S. Here 50S plus 30S equals to 70S. S stands for Swedberg unit or sedimentation coefficient. S means Swedberg unit or the sedimentation coefficient. 50S and 30S. 50S and 30S. 30S gets superimposed. 20 units gets superimposed. I am sorry, 10 units gets superimposed. And it forms the 70S. It is not the 80S. It is not mathematics. Like 50S plus 30S equals to 80S. It is the 70S. So, we have clearly understood the prokaryotic cell as well as eukaryotic cell. Now, if in the examination, if the question comes, differentiate between the prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells, we have already covered. Just put a line in between the prokaryotic cells and the eukaryotic cells. Just demarcate these two with the help of this line. Point number one, prokaryotic cell is unicellular or multicellular. In case of prokaryotic cell, it is unicellular. In case of eukaryotic cell, it is unicellular or multicellular, and in prokaryotic cell, it is unicellular. Then in eukaryotic cell, it is the cell wall is cellulose. In case of prokaryotic cell, the cell wall is mucopeptide. In case of eukaryotic cell, nucleus is true. In case of prokaryotic cell, the nucleus is primitive. In case of eukaryotic cell, the cell organelle is present, that is prokaryotic cell, cell organelles are absent. In case of eukaryotic cell, ribosome is 80S, and in case of prokaryotic cell, the ribosome is 70S. In eukaryotic cell, the example is from algae to angiosperm, and prokaryotic cell, the example is bacteria. So, I think you have understood the prokaryotic cell, difference between the prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. So, what I have discussed in this video, you will get in our website called Science Recorner, sciencerecorner.com. You please log on to sciencerecorner.com. You will get whatever I have said just now. You get in the sciencerecorner.com website, and all these things we have discussed, you will get in the description below. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and please do subscribe so that you get the notification as and when we upload the new videos. Thank you.